Thank you. 10 minutes. I have 10 minutes to speak about a subject that perhaps you know already well, which is the collaboration between startups and large companies. But first, let me try to guess why you are here today. So when I was looking at the list of attendees, there is VCs, startups, corporation. I guess you're not just here to listen to each other, but also to learn a few things, and also you're here because you believe you can create some business opportunity. If you are a startup, you are growing a business, you are you have a good technology, you need visibility, you need access to a market, you need funding. If you are a corporation, you're also growing a business, you're trying to improve the performance of your business, you need to access fresh ideas, you need to access new technologies, you need to remain relevant, you need differentiation. So when you look at these two examples, you see that there should be naturally some ways to find a mutual benefit between a startup company and a large corporation to work together. But for the one, the persons here in this room who have been in this situation before, you know that this can also be very challenging. And my question working in a large corporation is how can we create the situation where we can establish a strong partnership between startup companies and my corporation. So that's going to be the subject of my my discussion today. I'm Yann Moreau, I work for Veolia. Veolia is the French-based international company. The headquarters is here in Paris. We are providing services to municipalities and to industrial clients in the areas of water, waste, and energy. Just to give you an idea of the size of the company, it's 25 billion euros in revenue and 160,000 employees worldwide. So let me go back to the initial question in the introduction. How do we it makes sense for large companies and startup to do business together? How do we create mutually this benefit? Large company like Veolia had for many years dedicated team working on open innovation, meaning that we are trying to identify growth opportunities or performance by looking at emerging solution and technology that are outside the company. And the role of this team is basically trying to be visible, trying to engage with the startups, and trying to find a match with a business unit that could have an interest to apply and adopt the innovation. This is often represented as the open innovation funnel. When you start large, you study and you look at different opportunities, and while you move along the funnel, you select the one that makes the most sense, and then you arrive with one or two where you hope that you will lead, that will lead to a partnership. I think this approach has been legitimate and that was the right approach for years. But now we and my company are experiencing few challenges with this approach. And I will explain in the next two slides what are the main challenge. The first one is that the ecosystem and the entrepreneurial landscape that we knew 10 years ago when we started to do open innovation has changed considerably. There's new initiatives, there's obviously constantly new startups, there's new incubators, there's new tech initiatives all the time. And before, when we were well connected to the ecosystem, we managed to have a good view of what's happening. Now it's almost a full-time job to just properly be connected with the ecosystem. Also, being visible and being connected brings you a lot of opportunities, but there are opportunities that you don't choose. And to be very honest with you, very few are real opportunities for our business units. So you have to ask yourself, where do you put your time, where do you put your energy when you are conducting such an approach? The second big challenge that we see is really linked to the adoption of innovation. When you adopt an innovation, either as an individual or as a company, it's always a decision. It's a decision between the benefit that this innovation will bring you and the effort you will need to implement it. the budget, the new learning, and also sometimes the risk. So when we go to a business unit with an emerging solution and discuss with our operators, what we want to hear and where we want to be, we want to be in a must-have situation. We want to hear, yes, we really want this solution. We have been looking for a solution like that for years. How much does it cost? When can I get it? But if we arrive and the feedback we get is, yes, that's very nice, that's very clever, I like this solution, it's more a nice-to-have situation. And here, believe me, the journey towards establishing the partnership will be very long and very very uncertain. So what do we do to be able to create this situation, this must-have situation? So here I'll go back to the funnel. We are basically flipping the funnel. Instead of starting by exploring what's happening outside the company, we are exploring and trying to find the must-have situation within the company. So we are working with our business units to sometimes using some creativity and problem-solving techniques to identify their challenge and also uncover some new opportunities. We also work with them to understand whether open innovation is really relevant for sorting out their issue. If the partnership with a startup company is really what they're looking for, we're looking at the chance of success. Sometimes we may have a lot of knowledge internally and on the specific subject, and we know that along the pathway of establishing the partnership, that could be one of the barriers that will occur at some point. So really, we're working on finding this must-have situation. Once we have it, once we have a good understanding of where we want to go, how we want to go, when we have the specification of what we are looking, then we try to be internally a little bit innovative too. And we have packaged everything we are doing in open innovation as a service for our business unit. The service that we offer, where we can conduct sourcing of technology worldwide based on the specification, but also we support them to analyze, compare, and shortlist all the solutions we can find for them. And then we are also generally going to the test and pilot phase to really de-risk and evaluate with our business unit the new solution. And we also provide some support to establish the partnership. I think I'm close to the 10 minutes. I will conclude by saying that this flipping the funnel exercise is something that is new for us. We designed it a few months ago. But the feedback we got and the first responses from our business unit has been pretty amazing. We are already overbooked. We are engaged in many different projects, going from technology focus, sensors, models, very specific treatment technologies. We are working on operational health and safety. They're asking us to work on customer engagement, a very large variety of topics. And I think that the fact we've transformed everything we do into this service is also something that is very clear. And if we are in a must-have situation, and if at the end of this exercise we manage to really match their expectation in terms of technology, but also potential deal, I think there's a big chance to reach this point where we will have a strong partnership. Just to finish, I want to say that I read a few weeks ago, and especially in a conference like this where you have so many presentations, how people can really why people would remember a presentation and not another one. And I said there was three things. The first thing is either the presentation has to be funny, the other one is has to be shocking, or it has to be informative. So I'm happy to see that no one laughed at my presentation yet. don't see anyone shocking, so I hope this was informative for you. Thank you for listening, and really don't hesitate to contact us. We are very happy to share our experience. We are flipping the Open Innovation funnel, and we are running Open Innovation as a service. Thank you.